YouTube and everyone watching, this is my first video in about 2 or 3 weeks, so sorry if I haven't been making videos. I've just been working a lot, and you might notice that I'm wearing the same clothes as I was in the last video that I made, and I promise that I have actually washed and cleaned myself, so I'm not like a tramp or anything. I'm quite clean. But this video today is going to be about an album review of an artist that I think is quite underrated in the charts, but it's Ellie Goulding's new second album called Halcyon, and I got sent this by a friend because I couldn't be asked to go and buy it, basically, because I'm so lazy. And so if you want to know what the album cover looks like, because I don't actually have a physical copy, I'm such a bad fan, here it is. Okay, so if you know Ellie Goulding, and you know her first album, Lights, which was her first album, you'll know that she has got quite a sort of alternative sort of instrumentally sort of synthy sound to her. She's got a really good voice, like it's very distinctive, and it's quite her vocal range is like incredible. So if you liked her first album, I think the comparison between the first and second album, I think it's like it's the same but different. Because like I think she's gotten a very sort of electronic influence to her sound. I mean, it's not like dubstep or anything, but it's like very synthy, sort of quite very electronic sounding, and amongst like a lot of percussion and like sort of drums. And yeah, I mean, it sort of reminds me a little bit of Florence's material, like her album. That's very sort of quite haunting, I think, is the right word to use. So yeah, have a listen and you'll see what I mean, I hope. To the album, back to Ellie's album, Halcyon, I actually wasn't sure what the word Halcyon actually meant, so I did a little bit of research and looked up on a dictionary. Halcyon actually means sort of like happy and joyful, carefree, sort of like halcyon weather, like really nice weather, happy and joyful, basically. And I think that's a really good word to use to describe this album, because it really is it's quite uplifting, and it really makes you more like, I don't know, just it makes you really happy and yeah, uplifted. Uplifted is a good word to use. I won't really go like on a track by track listing of like every single song, and like for some reason there's how many songs? There's 14 tracks. No, there's 13 tracks on the album, and like there's a couple of deluxe tracks at the end, and a remix by Calvin Harris, and like you might have heard of him. He's done a few remixes of other artists as well. He's quite popular. Oh no, wait, there's 13. Yeah, there is 13 tracks, I did say yes. There's 13 tracks, and for some reason I only have 11. But, I'll give you the track listing now. It's, 1, Don't Say a Word. 2, My Blood. 3, Anything Could Happen, which is the first single of the album. You'll probably recognise it. It's probably in the background maybe, but, it's the one that goes ee 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 ee. at the start, you probably know it. That's that one, that's the first single. 4 is Only You, 5 is Halcyon, 6 Figure 8, 7 Joy, 8 Hanging On, which is going to be the second single, 9 Explosions, 10 I Know You Care, 11 Atlantis, 12 Dead in the Water, and the last bonus track is I Need Your Love, which is a Calvin Harris sort of remix-ish. So yeah, that's the track listing. My favourite so far, I've listened to the album quite a few times now, and I've heard Anything Could Happen like loads on the radio. It's like been way overplayed, but I've not been tired of it yet actually. My favourites anyway are probably I really like, and obviously Anything Could Happen, that's a really good starter for a single, opener I mean. 4, Only You, I really like Only You. That's such an amazing, like, it's just got such a epic chorus, and like she uses such like sort of electronic sounds to really make it buzz more and like make it more, it sounds really spiritual at the same time, like it just really makes you more like wanting and motivated. I mean, oh yes. And the next, my other favourite is probably, I really like Hanging On actually. And also Atlantis, I really love that song, I've just been listening to it over and over and over again. I mean, her voice is just like, I can't fault it, it's just like her, like how high she's able to get. I mean, I don't think I'd be able to do that, and oh my goodness, it's just like the start of Atlantis, it's sort of, it almost reminds me of the beginning of like a Bruce Springsteen track, if I can get away with saying that. Just like just the start of the piano at the beginning, the sort of like echoey sound of the piano, it just sort of, it's quite nostalgic actually. All of it, if I was to summarise, I'd definitely say it's very, it gets in your head, and even though a lot of it is quite repetitive, like Anything Could Happen, it just like she repeats that phrase over and over again, but I didn't get tired of it because it's just so choral and like epic and awesome, and just the sounds that she creates, like she mingles percussion with like electro synth. That's what, if I could like use a genre, I'd use electro synth to give it one. That's the sound, I think. There's lots of drums and sort of echoey sort of sounds, pipes, I think she uses. Her voice is just like amazing. I mean, oh, her vocal range, she's so talented, she can just do so much, it has so much potential, she could just do anything with it. Yeah, that's the album basically. I haven't got the deluxe, I've just been listening to the standard one, but I mean, if you were a fan of Ellie Goulding before, then I definitely recommend that you get this, because I did sort of like her before, but with like her old album, I didn't actually have her old album. I listened to like, you know, the songs Starry Eyed, Your Song, which obviously was on the John Lewis advert last year, and she was actually at my student summer ball last year, so I got to see her there as well. But yeah, definitely, I know like her style's changed, but it hasn't changed that much. And like a little bit of trivia for you, she did go out with Skrillex for a little bit, not for too long, which sort of surprised me, but that, I think that's where she got some of her electro influences from. But yeah, really, really good album. I'd probably rate it 5 stars. Yeah, definitely. I'm going to go see her in December on the 12th. With my friend Nick, who I keep mentioning because he's awesome. But yeah, it really is such a good album and you should definitely go and buy it. It's definitely worth your money. So yeah, that's Ellie Goulding's Halcyon for you. Yeah, that was my album review. Yeah, and if you have any questions, if you feel there's anything I've missed out, if anything's there's anything you want to ask, doesn't have to be about Ellie Goulding, could be about anything, just put them in the comments box. This has been quite a short video, shorter than my other ones, but I'm not sure what my next video is going to be. Some news I do have though is that I'm going to go to the Born This Way ball again. Yes, again, because I'm just can't get enough in Oslo in Norway in about 2 weeks' time. So I'll probably do a video reviewing that, which will be awesome. Don't judge me because I'm a fan. Anyway, yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Yeah, bye.